He knows me.
Okay.
Some people know.
Ready to go.
Just chat with me over here.
Yeah.
How are you feeling today? There was two rulings made. How do you feel about what the U.S. said today?
Being in the courts, you know, you start to know how you play your games. I mean, it's poker back and forth. The issues where he ruled against us were absolutely non-crucial issues. They needed to be raised for the sake of representing issues which the Tauche members wanted to raise, which they could not raise because of they didn't have any standing in this court. So I needed to raise at a very late date the charter issue, which I did. He denied that. It's fine. I can live with that. It's absolutely no problem. The other ruling, in a way, I have to say it was a matter of principle that you just don't take statements from people when they're 25 armed officers at your farm. You just don't do that. That's a matter of courtesy. You can phone later and say, well, can we sit down? Can we talk about that? It would be much easier to do that. The statement itself, which was admitted then, is in effect helping our case. It's absolutely not detrimental for our case. So I'm totally fine with it.
Okay. So thus far, I saw you 2 years ago when this was first starting up. How are you feeling so far in the case as far as the arguments against you have been raised? What are some of the key issues that have been brought up here, and how are you feeling about it?
I think I'm feeling very good for two reasons. The one reason is that it raised so much the awareness of the general public about this issue. Many things government is doing cannot be dealt with properly because the public doesn't know the background. So successfully, intentionally or unintentionally, government, I think, brought it on to themselves to bring it out in the public like that. It became a centerpiece for the last 2 years in public discussions. In regard to the legal argument, I think we're right on track what we want to do. If we don't win in the first round, I don't care because we go to the second round. Because it comes down, and I'm very, very optimistic about the charter issue, because it is so clear that the legislation which doesn't ban drinking milk and just transporting and selling milk is simply a commercial aspect of a law. And it's always translated into that it's a health issue. It cannot be only in Canada a hazardous, dangerous food product. It needs to be around the world in order to be justified that you have a law like that. And that is the basis of how we argue our charter issue.
In the end, after all is said and done, what would the ideal outcome be for you?
Okay, the ideal outcome, in that case, the ideal outcome would be that either the court forces the government to look at the issue, start a joint research on the issue, and then move forward to address the issue that people should have a right in their private capacity to make decisions, what they put in their mouth and what not.
And now, yesterday it was said by the justice that we need to get down to, I think it was the nitty gritty, and we need to get down to the fact that, is it the shareholders' argument? How did that go? And what are your thoughts about that?
I think that the judge is zeroing in rightly on the issue. All the nitty gritty, if the milk was white or green or blue, who cares? He wants to come down with, is it in effect a constitutional right that people can choose for themselves what they put in their body? Be it maple leaf can still distribute their cold cuts despite 20 people died last year. We have spinach where people died. We have salmonella cases where people died. It's a total arbitrary issue here, what is dangerous and what is hazardous, which is designed by, determined by the government. But we need also to understand that we have a marketing system here in Ontario and Canada where, in that case, dairy farmers of Ontario controlling have a monopoly on the entire milk supply. They have absolutely no interest to let that slip away. They want to control. It's all about money. It's all about control. And that is why, personally, I want to force this issue right into the public consciousness, that the public understands that the health issue is just a facade in order to protect monopoly in this country.
Since this has been raised, has it Have you had to stop selling the milk? Has it affected it in a positive or negative way?
It has affected me very positive, that I am so determined to keep going and I never stop.
So you've still been able to...
Yeah, I need to prove that nobody dies from it. Why should I stop now? Otherwise, I would agree it's a hazardous product.
And now, how many people is it? More than 150 people that have?
Well, I think it's 450 people.
Okay.
It's 150 families.
Okay.
And I need to state that again. These are mostly families with children, older people who have trouble digesting milk. So it's all people who actually have no choice but drinking raw milk because the pasteurized milk they cannot digest.
And what are the benefits?
You need to ask the culture members the benefits. I'm only milking, and I'm only doing what they're telling me. I'm providing a service. I know for me it's good. I don't know what they say why it's good. They're asking me to milk their cow. The cow has four teats. Every family has one teat off the cow, and they get the milk from that cow.
And you've been drinking it for your entire life?
Mm-hmm. I drank it at the moment I was born. And kept going. I just changed my mother to a cow.
Anything else you'd like to add?
No.
All right.